Thank you. My name is Catherine Hiller. I'm with the Financial Times. I wanted to come back to one remark you made earlier. You spoke about the need to deter China from using military force against Taiwan. Now, if we look at what has transpired over the last couple of years, that the current efforts at deterrence don't really seem to be working. So, and if we look at what China has done, you also referred to that earlier in the South China Sea before, we also seem to have failed at deterrence in that area. So I wonder if, options for improving deterrence featured at all in your conversations this week here, and like what ideas you have about that, and maybe some of your counterparts here in Taiwan. Thank you.
金融时报的提问，你大使您刚刚提到说应该要吓阻中国对台湾使用武力，但是我们如果看到过去几年的情况，其实我们做的吓阻并没有很有效，而且中国在南海的行为也是显示了我们吓阻行动的这个失败。那么在过去一周您跟访团来到台湾的这些会议里面，有没有谈到如何加深我们吓阻的能力？那么台湾方面也有没有提出什么样的看法？
So the FT has been covering this story well, and thank you for that question. There are a number of things that we need to do, and your question implies that not enough has been done, and you're right. But I will point out some of the things we have done. The United States under the Trump administration dramatically increased defense spending. We got our NATO allies to dramatically increase defense spending and reverse the sequestration and the massive cuts that had taken place in the prior administration.
那么感谢金融时报的提问，那么您的意思大概就是说我们需要去吓阻，可是我们做的不够，那么这样子的论点是正确的，但是我会在这边说我们做了哪些努力。在川普执政的时期大幅的提升了这个国防的预算，我们也让北约去提升他们的这个国防的预算，同时我们也解除了之前的政府的一些限制。
Taiwan itself has extended its conscription term of enlistment recently, which I think is a major step here in Taiwan, and Taiwan's committed to increasing its defense spending as well.
那么台湾最近呢延长兵役到一年，我认为这是一个跨出一大步，同时台湾在国防预算上面也大幅的增加，都是好事。
The U.S. has approved and Taiwan has paid for up to $20 billion in new weapons platform sales to Taiwan that will come online in the next several years.
那么，美国对台的这个军售也达到了200亿，在未来几年呢，希望会慢慢的交付。
But the premise of your question is right that more needs to be done because the Chinese have been engaged in the biggest peacetime military buildup we've seen since the Kaiser before World War II, engaged in a similar military buildup, or excuse me, before World War I, engaged in a very similar military buildup of his naval forces and his land forces.
那么您说的没错，我们需要加紧脚步，做得更多，因为我们看到中国是在这个陈平时期大幅的增加它的军备。那这个上一次发生这样的事，是一战、二战的时候，德国加强它的海军还有陆军的能力。
So we need to get the $20 billion in military equipment delivered as soon as possible to Taiwan.
所以我们希望这个200亿美元的军售能够尽快交付给台湾。
Now I'm for arming Ukraine and being the arsenal of democracy to help the Ukrainians fight the brutal invasion that their neighbor has engaged in Ukraine.
那么我也知道说乌克兰人他们是怎么样的来面对邻国俄罗斯这样残暴的入侵。
And supplying Ukraine is no doubt a challenge when we also need to supply Taiwan.
那么支持乌克兰其实是一个很大的挑战，那同时要协防台湾也是一个同样的挑战。
But it can't be an either-or situation. It can't be that we can help Ukraine but not Taiwan, or we can help Taiwan and not Ukraine. We have to help them both, and we need to figure out how to do that in the United States and increase our industrial base capacity in the defense industry.
但是我们不可以在乌克兰跟台湾之间做选择，两个我们都要去保护。所以美国国内我们也要加强自己的这个产业还有国防产业的能力。
But there are things Taiwan can do itself that don't rely on the United States. So, for example, hardening its aircraft hangars and bunkers, especially on the west coast of Taiwan. That's something that Taiwan can do, and it doesn't need the United States to do it. And Taiwan can build. Taiwan's got engineers. Taiwan's got the funds. They need to put the funds into strengthening Taiwan's resilience, especially with the Air Force.
那么台湾自己可以做到不需要依赖美国的事情也有很多，包括强化台湾的西岸的战机的停机坪、机场等等，这些是台湾不需要美国就可以做到。台湾自己有很好的工程师以及预算，这些预算应该用来提升台湾空军的韧性。
Another idea that I wrote about in the Wall Street Journal several years ago is that Taiwan needs to look at the Eastern European countries.And many of those countries have started shooting clubs. These are not territory reserves or army reserve bodies, but they're clubs to teach people on a broad scale how to handle a weapon safely, how to use a weapon safely, and those weapons are then stored by the government. So if there was an invasion of Poland or the Czech Republic or the Baltic states, that there'd be many citizens that would be prepared to receive a weapon and use it to defend their homes.
那么我前几年在《华尔街日报》有写一篇文章，讲到一件事情，就是台湾应该仿效中东欧的做法。中东欧有越来越多成立这种民间的组织，那它可能是由这些退役的军人来组成，他去教一般的平民如何安全的使用武器。那这些武器当然是由政府来做保管。所以假如说中东欧、波兰、捷克或者是渤海三国遇到战争的话，他们的平民可以跟政府拿到这些武器来保护自己。
And to have it be effective, this can't be a few thousand people. This has to be a million Taiwanese.And think how that would impact the leadership of the CCP if they knew that if they invaded, there'd be a million Taiwanese with an AK-47 using the same ammunition that the invaders were using, people around every corner, people in every apartment building that were willing to defend their homes.
那么要做到有效的这样子的吓阻，我们需要有不是几千人而已，要有全台湾这个所有的民众几百万人一起来学习这样子自我防卫的能力。那假如做到这样子的话，中国共产党的领导人一定会重新的思考，因为他 知道说，假如中共入侵台湾，那么每个平民都会配备这个 AK-47 步枪，就跟他们的军队一样，而且会在每个角落、每个大楼里面等着要这个杀敌，然后保家卫国。
And waiting until a war starts or an invasion is underway is too late. It has to happen before then to be a deterrent and to be effective.
那么等到战争真的爆发，再来做就来不及了，必须要在战争发生之前就做到有效的吓阻。
Now, I understand the issue of guns is sensitive in Taiwan. It's a different culture than in America. But protections could be put in place. People could be trained, and their guns could be stored in safes, like in Switzerland, where many men have and families have a gun in the safe that's provided by the government, or they could be held in armories and be ready to distribute quickly in the event of an invasion.
那么我了解枪支在台湾是一个敏感的议题，台湾的文化跟美国不同，但是我认为我们可以做到有效的给人民的训练，然后教导他们如何安全的使用武器，并且安全的存放武器。就例如瑞士的做法，政府有提供这些这个保险箱来存放武器，或者是统一在这个军火库里面保管。
And those legitimate concerns about gun ownership or gun safety pale in comparison when we look at the war crimes that have taken place, the crimes against humanity that have taken place in Ukraine.People being killed extrajudicially, the rapes, the children being taken away from their homes and shipped to other parts of the country. Having a weapon will help Taiwanese protect themselves, and it will help deter the Chinese from an invasion. And that's the whole point. We don't want an invasion. We don't want a war. We want peace. But the best way to show the Communist Party of China that you want peace is to deter them and to show that you're strong. We need to do it in America, but Taiwan needs to do it as well.
那么对于枪支安全的这些忧虑呢，其实如果跟这个乌克兰我们看到的反人类罪还有这些战争的罪行比起来，其实微不足道。在乌克兰我们看到人民受到屠杀，受到强暴，儿童被迫离开自己的家园到国内其他的地方。假如说拥有武器的话，台湾人就可以保护自己，并且吓阻中共的入侵。这就是我想要说的重点。我们不想要看到入侵，也不要有战争，我们追求的是和平。要告诉中国共产党我们追求和平，最好的做法就是吓阻他们，告诉他们我们有实力，美国和台湾在这方面都要做到一样的事情。